Hello, everyone. Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. Once again, check it out. Viper released his new version of the Peterbilt 389. We'll be driving that today. We are in Spokane, Washington, and we're going to go to Seattle. So across the entire state for the most part. I'm using all my mods that I've been using for a while. So that includes the real tires mod, it's 389 by Viper. I've got a realistic graphics mod by FRKN64 and some other ones. At the very end of this video, we'll go into my mods and I will show you exactly what I'm running. And you can look those up and use them yourself. All right, let's go ahead and fire this baby up. Turn the ignition on. We're using that beautiful Cat C15 engine. It sounds so good. It really does. Big thanks to Thrustmaster for sponsoring the wheel cam. A link for everything I use will be in the description below. Remember, I don't make a dime off of that. That is just to help you guys. We are picking up some pressure tanks, I believe, or something along those lines. That's on the other side, I think. Well, let's turn our flashers on, shall we? I do have voice navigation on. A lot of people wanted me to check that out, so we will be doing that. I don't have a mod that changes that to Google or anything like that. We can do that. Oh, there it is right there. Okay. We can do that in a bit, or next time, actually. But I want you to hear the one that comes with the game. And we're using Sky. That's her name. Oh, Sky. Early morning here in Spokane. Let's back it up to the trailer to the right. We'll clear that, no problem. Going to R1H. And pop it on back. All right. Been really enjoying Washington so far. This has been a really cool state. A lot of stuff to see. And we don't get to see it all, even whenever we, do our thing. So it's pretty crazy how much there is to do and see in this DLC, I've got to say. All right, almost there. Let's drop it into that one there. Try to hit the kingpin in one shot. Come on, baby. Got it. Look at that. That wasn't too bad, was it? Let's pull the trailer brakes. Go outside and we'll do a tug test here. So going to low, low. That's not low, low. This is low, low. Oh yeah, that's good to go. That is definitely good to go. Pull that, push that in. Let's go ahead and attach the trailer. And we're going to be good to go here. Let's turn the flashes off like that. Parking brake in. Let's rock and roll, folks. On out of the yard we go. This is a new place. I've never seen this place before, called Steeler. It's a new... I used the real, company's mod, real logo 3D. So I don't know if Steel's real or not, or Steeler. I don't think it is. I think this is just a, one of the made up ones, kind of like Walbert and all that, you know? I mean, time will tell. Cool little gate right there for deliveries. Don't need a job offer. We are good on that. Thank you very much.
Turn right.
So that's Sky. She's kind of annoying. Most of them are that way. But you know what? Maybe that'll help us, especially since we have been making some mistakes last time we drove in Washington. So I want to make sure that we don't make those mistakes again, and she'll help us do that. There we go. Look at that. That's pretty sweet. Okay, we'll turn right here.
Turn right.
Oh, those are just clouds. I thought that was a mountain range or something there. It's not. Okay, turn right. We will. We're just going to go ahead and go since they're stopped, and we can make a red on red, so why not? All right. So I want to talk a little bit. I know we briefly mentioned the new flight simulator that is going to be coming out next year that was released or was announced at E3. I do want to talk about that a little bit. So I'll wait till we get a little further in our journey here. Go straight on. You got it. It's 35 through here, so no need to go too crazy. Going to 6 high. Nice little creek there. Oh, that is gorgeous with the real realistic graphics mod. I'm telling you right now, that is going to be beautiful once this sun gets up in the air. What are we doing up here, folks? Plane's going pretty slow. Ooh, that's nice. I'm not using a traffic density mod. I was getting some game crashes with the latest version of that. So, unfortunately, we'll have to wait until that gets sorted. The gas station here. And there's a, let's see.
Keep right, and then turn right.
Okay, keep right, then turn right. So, basically, get on the highway, right? Yes, I believe so. Turn right. Okay. Don't see anybody going, so we're gonna go. This lane ends and dumps us right onto the highway. I'm gonna try to pay attention to the RPMs this time. I got a little sloppy last time. Okay, that just is the end of the road as we see it there. We're gonna get over one more to the middle lane since we don't need to exit here. I drove over from the dam like last time and just came right east to Spokane, so I did see a little bit of scenery. I noticed that the Spokane airport was there, but it wouldn't let you exit there, so I don't know if it's modeled or not. I don't. There we go. Now we can just sip some fuel at 1,000 RPM and slowly bring her up to 60 miles per hour. It's got an interesting ratio on it, doesn't it? Pullman. Man, look at the detail here. Oh, nice. Amtrak train. That was cool. That was really cool. Go outside view here in a second. Just look around. Look at that. All the evergreens. Beautiful. Really cool stuff, man. Ooh, they're slowing down up here, aren't they? Everett Express, Sunoco. Oh, it's all because that guy. That guy's going real slow. He's got everybody wound up. Yeah, see Spokane Airport there in Arondo. We are up to 60. We're going to set it and forget it. Let's do it. All right. Now we can just enjoy the scenery. For the most part, I'm going to get over to the right, but that right lane ends, so we're not going to do that now. So nice having Viper 389 back in service. I do love this truck. And I went with some different headlights on this one. Just the old square ones. Ooh, 70 through here. Well, we'll just hang into 60 for right now. Look at this. This is looking cool. Nice and barren. That is nice. Super, super nice. How about that? Those views. They are gorgeous. They are. All right, let's get back to driving so we don't kill ourselves by rubbernecking. I tend to do that whenever a new state comes out, you know that. So yeah, let's talk a little bit about Microsoft Flight Simulator that was announced at E3. Ritzville, Washtukana. Don't drink or drive safely is what it says. Okay. They announced it at E3. A lot of people were like, why would you do that? Compared to, like, you know, Flight Sim Expo or something. Flight Sim Expo, you know, only had like 1,500 people there, or 1,577. And I've got to say that, you know, I mean, that's a lot of people in person, but the outreach you get from the E3 is just so much higher. So I can understand why Microsoft would decide to do it that way. But they, you know, they announced it. Keep left. They announced it and everybody lost their absolute minds, including myself. You know, I'm not, you know, I love X-Plane 11, but I'm not saying that X-Plane 11's the end-all be-all. You know, having these new simulators that are on, you know, the newest technology is very, very welcome in the community. I don't ever invest into a sim. I know that, you know, a sim can expire at any given moment. And I think everybody should kind of take a page out of that book. Boy, look at the grass here. This looks great. This looks really nice. Here in Ellensburg. So that was a big thing that was announced, and it looks beautiful. Let me know if you guys want me to do a trailer breakdown of that. I don't know if there's any interest in that or not. Or maybe I decided, by the time this video goes out, maybe I decided that, you know, I did that. I'm recording this one in the same day I did my last one, so that's why. I'm wearing the same shirt. No, I don't wear the same shirt every day. Sorry to disappoint. So sorry to disappoint you. We're outside of Moses Lake. If you're familiar with the area, there's Moses Lake right there. Got boats, nice. Nice, nice, nice. I'm not sure where we're gonna be dropping these pressure tanks at, but hopefully it's gonna be... Oh no, we're not going to Everett, so we won't get to see Darwin, which is Boeing. But hey, we'll be in that side, so maybe the next time we'll get to drive, we'll get to haul special cargo from Darwin. That would be pretty neat. Boy, this is beautiful, man. This is really nice. I'm just gonna keep saying it, but it really is. Got a rest area up here. Look at that sidewalk action there. That is nice. Wowee. Oh, we got a bunch of power lines coming up here too. Good on fuel. We're doing everything right now. We're just hanging out here in this lane and doing our thing. On this wonderful morning in Washington. Get over for this guy so we can get on the highway. You need me in your way, buddy. Now the trailer mods that you've seen out there, those are from the SISL trailer pack. That Ford Air one looks really cool. I saw Sinclair there just a minute ago. There's a lot of good stuff there. I think we can hold our speed going up this hill. Just a maybe. Nope. Let's go ahead and just turn off cruise control, drop down into 8 low. Go back to manual mode here. One more cruise. I think we can get up to scenic view 1 mile. Oh, we're gonna have to check it out. We're good. I was gonna downshift here. Yeah, let's do it. Might as well. Getting up this hill. So scenic view in 1 mile. Should see it very soon. Look at that vista over there on the right. Here it is right here. We're gonna pull in and have a look. That's what it's all about, man. Seattle. Or not Seattle, Washington DLC. I want to check this out for sure. Let's try not to take out a sign while we do this. There we go.
Recompute.
Yeah, you can recompute all you want. We're just going to go have a look here. Look at that. Isn't that a beauty? Isn't that just about a beauty? Nice. Looks like we're going over that that bridge there pretty soon. Okay, I'm going to turn those lights off. Let's keep our secondaries on. Let's get on out of here. Nice silver Peterbilt. I love that metallic silver. Ice cream cones. Little ice cream truck there. Look at all the placement of the rocks all the way around. Pretty cool. All right, let's get on out of here, get back on the road. Most delicious. Pepsi trailer going on the road there. Let's get going before more traffic comes. We're in the clear right now. Oh no, we got a stop sign. Oops. We're good. Oh my lord, there's a crash over there. You see that? Wow. I don't know what happened there. Trailer damage. Oh, I hit the stupid sign. I had to go sightseeing, didn't I? That's all right. You're gonna make mistakes whenever you're looking at a bunch of stuff. That's gonna happen. You know, soon enough the newness of the state will wear off, and then we'll go back to driving good. Maybe. Have we ever driven good? Be careful going down this hill here. Columbia River, once again. That is cool. We cross this and then what? That's pretty much it. I'm gonna keep it in 8 low right now. I'm not gonna put the cruise on because we're gonna be climbing another hill, it looks like. That's one thing that is my peeve of the SISL trailer pack, man. Just in general, with any kind of realistic, I don't know, company mod, you just get tons of Walmart stuff, man. Just tons of it. And maybe that's just American Truck Sim that always puts those Walmart trailers out there, but... And it's just, it's a lot of Walmart in this game sometimes. A little too much. So anywho, I'm very excited about Microsoft Flight Simulator. You know, it's been so long, what, 13 years since we've had a flight simulator from them. You know, everybody's been putting the defibs on the ESP code, and it's time to say goodbye. I think it'll finally bury that code once and for all. Now, I've seen a lot of speculation, and I mean a lot of speculation about everything, and people talking about how it's, you know, it's going to be like FSX, it's going to be like Flight. There's no way to know that. There's zero evidence there. And I don't know why everybody's, you know, jumping the gun to say, oh, it's going to be a disaster. It's not going to be good. It's like, man, can we just give it a shot? Like, can we let it do its thing and see if it's, it becomes something? Now, when it comes to Microsoft Flight, I am impartial to that because, like I've said to many people, you know, I bought Flight a long time ago and I enjoyed it. I knew it wasn't, you know, a full-on sim like FSX was at the time, but I still enjoyed it. It was fun. It was just, you know, it was nice to hop into a plane and just go. And that's what, you know, it was all about. Let's set our cruise control now. It's just hazy out, isn't it, this morning. What's the time? Oh, it's 9:29 a.m., that's why. Not afternoon yet. So I don't know why we live in a, current time where people just are so quick to shoot down something new that comes out. But it just... It looks so good. Like, that looks so good. And it uses the satellite data, but it talks about Acer AI. And that's an interesting technology. And you notice in a lot of the trailer that there was so much Google Earth stuff happening there that looked amazing. Like, they can have essentially ortho scenery with buildings and cars and parking lots and stuff based off of that. Oh, we got pulled in for a vehicle inspection, folks. I'll shut up right now. Hold on. Why is my Jake brake not working? There it goes. That's because I didn't release the clutch quick enough. That's what happened there.
Okay, let's find a new route.
Hey, let's find a new route. Come on, Walgreens driver. Stop here. Outside of you, Tim. All right. Pass the inspection. Need your cooperation of a safe journey of 82,423 pounds. Look at that little road that goes back around to that lot. That's cool.
Go straight on.
We will. On Highway 90. That's a pretty good little on-ramp here. Is that Volvo gonna let us on? We're gonna... Yeah, he is. Okay. Thank you, buddy. Appreciate that. Say thank you. Alright. People will be trying to get up this hill. We're gonna be faster than this guy, so let's do it. We've got the horsepower today. And the torque to get it done. Now we go down the hill. And just kind of coast on down here. And get back up to speed. And just like that, we're back to 60 miles per hour. Yeah, I like this truck. I do. We got up here, man. That's a lot of cliff happening. I mean, with all this volumetric grass, like, I noticed, like, it's really good performance. It really is. All right, this is going to get interesting here. I thought it was going to be a lot more of a descent than that. Let me go back over to this guy. Look at that. That is awesome. This is a long bridge. Jake break down this hill. This is cool. It's kind of going with the flow of traffic right now. But also in that Microsoft Flight Simulator trailer, man. The AI for the birds and various wildlife looks so good. It really does. The weather looks amazing. Like, I believe we're actually going to get a flight simulator because them using the word simulator was everything. They know how monumental that word means to the community. And even if you go to their website for the sim, they talk about how they, you know, took input from the community and all this stuff. So it's not like they're just ignoring everyone. They wanted to make a sim that everybody would like. Coming over. Sorry, car. You guys are just going a little slow for me. 10 under. So how can we not want something like that, you know? Today's technology. Now, a lot of people are all butthurt because... Oh, what we got up here? Hold on. I'll hold that thought. We got suggested speed limits? Yes, we do. Look at that. Suggested speed limit is 50 based on the flow of traffic right now and their LED signs. That is cool. I knew that was part of the update. Man, look at this. Oh, is it a helicopter? I think a helicopter just flew over us. It sounded like it. Gonna kind of coast back to 50 here. Not trying to speed. Ooh, that's a little bit of a hill, but we'll get speed going again here. Come on. Into the tunnel we go. It's 45 in here, so that worked out just fine. Seattle discovered, folks. Turn our lights on for safety here. We got exit north, Portland, half mile. I've been through a bunch of tunnels in Seattle whenever I was there for the convention, which I know they got the convention center modeled. We'll see if we can point it out. Okay, we can get over to the right and exit right. Look at those LED signs. That is cool. Good stuff, man. Still suggested 50 miles per hour. Downtown Washington, or Seattle. Man, I'm getting those so backwards. Because when I fly to Washington in the Sims, like, you know, X-Plane, it's Seattle. I don't know. It's a little dyslexic today, I guess. Now we're on Highway 5, and that takes you all the way, man. All the way across the entire West Coast. And we can do it now. We're going to have to do that soon in a stream or something, but do the entire West Coast run. See how long that would take. Okay, we should see the convention center up here soon. I think it's after this tunnel here. Let's have a look and see. Careful now, careful. There it is right there, Washington State Convention Center. That is where PAX West is. That is neat. I'm glad they have that modeled. Get over one lane here. We're not exiting. This is really detailed for Seattle. Like, really detailed. Darwin facility. Are we going to get to see it? I'm going to keep left. We are going through Everett. Darwin Freeway. That's where Boeing is. Darwin in this game. We might be able to get a glimpse of it here as we go on the north side of Everett. It's like this is our exit. Let's do it. Okay.
Exit right.
Exit right. At released the clutch a little too fast on that one. There we go.
Turn left.
Everett City Center. We might get to see Darwing. I don't know. Man, that's what we're going to do next. If we can get a run out of there, that'd be amazing. Some aviation in your American Truck Simulation. It's been a really gloomy morning to drive today. All the way to Seattle. We're going to go. I think we're going to see it. We're going to go through Everett. Right turn up here. Is somebody getting in an accident? Looks like it. Trying to figure it out there. Yep, he's backing up. What is he doing?
Turn right.
Turn right. I do like having the navigation, though. That's pretty cool. But people have been doing all sorts of different kinds. That's like a Morgan Freeman one. I want you to make a left turn.
To
turn left. Okay. I saw that one. There's the Google Maps
turn
one.
Left.
I haven't seen an Apple Maps one yet, but we'll have to do the Google one if I can get that one working. That'd be pretty cool. Everett discovered, folks. Welcome to Everett. Miles per hour through here. That big old Walmart
left.
Right there.
And then turn left.
Keep right, then turn left. Is that what she said? I think so.
Turn right.
She said, keep right, then turn right. I gotcha. Factory outlet, Supreme, all sorts of different new stuff here I've never seen before. No, she said right and then just left. I don't know. But this is the way we're going. Maybe we need to get back over to the right. I'm thinking that's what we need to do. Draw bridge. Be prepared to stop. Oh, man. Is he going to let me over? Thank you, buddy. Appreciate that. Say thank you for that one. This is one of those draw bridges that can... there's a ship that just went through there. So I think we're in the clear on that. That looks amazing. That's really cool stuff. Keep right. Because we're not going to Vancouver, British Columbia, but man, that's cool to see that sign, isn't it? We're that far north.
Get ready to turn left. Turn left.
We will turn left here, which is a big, huge U-turn. But we're going underneath the freeway, it looks like. We yield to them, but I don't see anybody coming. We seem to be good there. Awesome. We go back across the same road we're just on. You get where we're going? Yeah, this drawbridge there. Got it. Got that memo. Boats coming through here right now. I need to get a screenshot, so let me do that, and then I'll be right back before we get where we're going. Okay, I will. Don't worry about it. All right, make it right here. Into Caterpillar, it looks like, is where we're dropping these things off. Where at? Back in here? Maybe in there. Let's look and see. Okay, go straight ahead, looks like. And then around the corner.
Get ready to turn left.
We did. At our destination. We're dropping right there. Okay. Doesn't seem too bad. Well, let's go around the whole thing and just look. Just look at it. Check out this. A big old pile of rubble there. Can we go around that way? I don't think so. Oh yeah, we can. Moving that car, that's cool. On the dirt. All the cars and that is neat. All that junk. Get rid of all that junk. That's cool. We'll go over here and we'll drop. To me, it just makes more sense to go around this way and get a pretty good straightened approach on it. Can't beat that. Oh, look at that, all beat up. The truck. We've seen that model before in other states. They've used it plenty of times. Okay, this is where they want it, so let's go straight and then just back it straight on in. We should be good. It shouldn't be too hard to pull off. I say that now, but honestly, it shouldn't be bad. Especially with that kind of trailer. All right, let's start doing it. Do it to it. Just back in right with the trailer. We should be good here. There we go. All the way this way. Just watching. Make sure we don't hit anything over there. Be nice and straight. Couldn't change a thing right there. That's pretty good. There we go. Parking brake. Flashes come off. Have a look outside. That looks amazing. And let's go ahead and detach the trailer. See what we got. Job completed. Pressure tank delivered from Spokane to Everett. Driven distance, 360 miles. Took 8 hours and 50 minutes and 49.4 gallons of fuel. Folks, that's going to do for this episode of American Truck Sim. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. I will see you next time. Take care.